Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and in this video, I share 8 Google Calendar tricks you might not even know existed. gcal is chock full of great features, some more well known than others. So in no particular order, here are my top 8 gcal tips and hidden features. The first one, I'm doing a combo of 3 together because I feel like these 3 are the basics of everything you're going to do in your Google Calendar. And that's add a calendar, create a calendar, and share a calendar. To add a calendar, click in the area on the left that says add a calendar. Here, Google will auto-populate some contacts for you. You can either choose one of those or type in the email of the calendar you want to add, then just click request access. Once that person okays your access, you'll have the calendar populated on the left-hand side under the other calendar section. To populate that calendar along with yours, just toggle it on. The check mark means you'll now have that calendar's events populated on your gcal. Now to create a calendar, say one that has everybody's birthdays or anniversaries or something, click the menu icon to the right of the add a calendar box. Click create new calendar. Here, you can name your calendar, add a description, and update the time zone. Then just click create calendar. Once a calendar is created, you can edit it and share it. So to share a calendar, click on the menu to the right of the cal name and select settings and sharing. You can also head to settings and then click on the cal on the left-hand side. So you can either click the get shareable link option or click the share with specific people option and manually add the emails you'd like to share the cal with. Here's a little bonus for you. As you add all your calendars, quickly color code them by clicking that menu icon to the right of the cal name and selecting a color. Okay, now that you have all your calendars set up, it's time to add holidays and other cool events. Head into your settings again, it's that gear icon, and select the add calendars dropdown. Then select browse calendars of interest. You can add a bunch of holidays here or even your favorite sports team, so you'll always know when they're playing. Heck yeah. So now once you add it, you'll find that in the other calendar section as well on the left-hand side. Did you know you can use a ton of keyboard shortcuts in gcal? Well, you can. I've linked to the full list below, but some of the coolest ones are to quickly create an event, just hit the C key. To change the cal view, you can hit 1 or D for day, 2 or W for week, 3 or M for month view, or 4 or X for 4-day view. Next, drag and drop events on your cal. If you need to adjust an event or meeting on your calendar, no need to edit it, just drag and drop it to the desired day. Now that you have your events populated, it's time to stay organized by getting a daily agenda email notification. To get an overview of your day's events, head back to your settings, and on the left, click the calendar that you want agendas from. Select General Notifications, then in the Daily Agenda section, click the drop-down to the right and select Email. To further your organization, use Tasks in your Google Calendar. To the right of your calendar, there's a tiny blue circle. That's the task icon. Just click on that and select Add a Task. You can click the pencil icon to the right of your tasks to edit and add a description. And then just mark your task complete when they're done. Okay, up next, find a time that works for everyone. When you click to add an event, select More Options. From this page, select the Find a Time tab. To the right, add the desired guests by email. Their calendars will appear here now, and gcal will automatically tell you if they're busy when you're trying to schedule that appointment. The last one on the list is a tip for all you business owners out there. Block off your appointment schedule. This is one that works on my business Google account, not my personal. To create an appointment schedule, click a day when you'll be free and select the appointment slots option. You can add a title like availability and customize the slot details. Hit save and you'll notice the icon of your event title has changed to a little box. If you click on that event, you can then click on go to appointment page for this calendar. Now this is where other people can schedule a time with you. Whoa, You can just share this URL to have people book you in your desired availability. Sweet. Those are my favorite Google Calendar tips. What are some of your favorite tips and hidden features? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I wanna know, so give it a like, a share, or leave a comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, or somewhere up here to watch another video. See you next time.